हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ एंटी एंजाइनल ड्रग्स। इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द प्रीवियस पार्ट, नाइट्राइट्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन। नाउ नेक्स्ट टू इट वी विल सी द रिमेनिंग कंपाउंड्स। सो द नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी इज बीटा ब्लॉकर। सो बीटा ब्लॉकर डू नॉट हैव एनी एक्शन ऑन द ब्लड वेसल एट सच, नाइदर कोरोनरी आर्टरी नॉर एनी अदर इफेक्ट। सो दे आर नॉट अ वासोडायलेटर, इवन दे नॉट डू नॉट इंप्रूव द हार्ट परफ्यूजन, that is a improvement in the coronary blood flow like this way. But they have a very fantastic effect that they improve the hemodynamics. So, and this hemodynamic improvement, that is they decreases the sympathetic tone, they decreases the requirement, etc. So by doing that other work, they decreases the oxygen consumption of the heart, and by that way they improve the heart performance, and therefore they are extremely useful, and by decreasing the sympathetic activity. So they decreases the heart rate, they decreases the blood pressure indirectly by decreasing the sympathetic tone, then contractility is also reduced, and by that way they decreases the myocardial oxygen consumption, and leading to the rest to the heart and duration of exercise. During the exercise and at the rest, the consumption of oxygen has been reduced. So they are effective specifically in silent kind of ischemia. They reduces the morbidity and mortality. But the only adverse effect which related to the beta blocker is that they cannot be used in a bronchospasm. The patient with asthma or COPD, they cannot be given. Hypoglycemia they induces. So the angina pectoris patient, if it is having the problem of diabetes, it is creating little bit a complication situation. Hyperlipidemia they induces, and in large dose they produces the bradycardia, AV nodal blockers, or bradyarrhythmia, fatigue. So these are the some side effect of the beta blockers. Next category is calcium channel blockers. Examples are verapamil, nifedipine, diltiazem, etc. So specifically they are used in variant angina where there is an spasm of blood vessels. So they relaxes the coronary smooth muscle, coronary vasodilation actions they are getting, and thereby they improve the coronary circulations. So they dilate the blood vessels. In previously beta blocker does not dilate, here they exactly work on the another way. So there is an increased coronary blood flow by vasodilation and decreased myocardial consumption. Myocardial consumption is also decreased here, and decreased peripheral resistance. So thereby they are used in extranial angina, they can also be used. So there is one disadvantage or limitations to this is that reflux increase in the sympathetic tone, and this may precipitate but aggravate the angina. So reflex sympathetic tone, it is one of the typical adverse effect which is related to the calcium channel blocker. So to overcome this sympathetic tone reflex activity, they can be given along with the beta blockers. So one of the side effect which is to the calcium channel blocker can be blocked by the beta blockers. So if co-current administration of beta blocker, they will be benefited. And thereby, they also beta blocker will reduce the reflex in sympathetic tone, whereas the oxygen demand also they will reduce, and they dilate the blood vessels. The calcium channel will dilate the blood vessels. So combinedly together, they give you very fantastic results. So combination with the nitrites also facilitate the vasodilation and reduces the preload. So calcium channel blockers are preferably be given along with the in combination with the other drugs. So next category of a drug is a potassium channel blocker. Nicorandil is one of the example for this. They are given in symptomatic ischemic heart disease. Specifically, they relaxes the coronary smooth muscle, causing the hyperpolarization via increase the transition of transmembrane potassium conductors. So here they work on an electrolytic mechanism. We have already seen this. Okay, so transient electrolyte transmembrane potassium conduction tends, it has been decreased by the potassium channel blocker. So there is an increased intracellular cyclic GMP similar to that of a nitrates, where there we have seen that cyclic AMP has been increased. Similarly here they also increases the cyclic AMP, and dilate divided both the normal and stenosed coronary artery. Coronary artery, which is normal even, or stenosed means which is constricted. So both they are dilated. They both reduces the preload as well as afternode, but does not produces the tolerance. One of the typical advantage of this here, that they do not produces any kind of a tolerance. This is one of the major adverse effect with the beneficiary effect of the potassium channel blocker. Effective in stable as well as vasoplastic anemia, but the limitation is that they have the very short duration of action. This is one of the limitation. Last category, fatty acid oxidase inhibitor. Ranolazine is a drug which is used for that. They inhibit the fatty acid oxidation, and by that way they act on this. So detailed mechanism here we will see. So by reducing that, they reduces the calcium load in the ischemic myocytes, and thereby they inhibit the late sodium current and sodium entry. So in ECG, electrocardiogram, we have seen the sodium entry, potassium entry, and calcium overload like that. So availability of a calcium is reduced by fatty acid oxidase inhibitor, and thereby they reduces the actin myosin interactions, and thereby the contractions spasm has been reduced. The main advantage is that they improve the exercise tolerance and frequency of anginal attack. They reduces. It is used to treat the cardiac failure, ventricular and supraventricular arrhythmia. The major side effect which are related to the fatty oxidase inhibitor is that they are having the constipation, dizziness, nausea, headache and palpitation, etc. They are the side effect. They are also contraindicated in the patient which are having pre-existing QT interval prolongation if they are having. Then again, few drug interactions they are having. Fatty acid will have the microsomal enzymatic induction property, few drugs which are interacting with this. So diltiazem, ketoconazole, macrolides, these are the drugs which inhibit the microsomal enzyme, and due to that the metabolism of fatty acid oxidase inhibitor is decreased, and therefore their plasma level is increased in these conditions. So this is what about the fatty oxidase inhibitors. So this is what about the anti-angiogenic drugs. If you have any kind of a query or any kind of a difficulty or doubts, you may contact directly in the given phone number, or you may mail me the given mail below. Thank you. Thank you very much.